السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
إن الحمد لله نحمده تعالى ونستهديه ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، أدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة، وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن استنى بسنته إلى يوم الدين. وبعد، إخوتي الكرام، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل، كما قال سبحانه: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد، واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم، أولئك هم الفاسقون. لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة، أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون. اللهم ارزقنا الإخلاص في القول والعمل، آمين يا رب العالمين. وعن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: من نفس عن مؤمن كربة من كرب الدنيا نفس الله عنه كربة من كرب يوم القيامة، ومن يسر على معسر يسر الله عليه في الدنيا والآخرة، ومن ستر مسلما ستره الله في الدنيا والآخرة. والله في عون العبد ما كان العبد في عون أخيه، ومن سلك طريقا يلتمس فيه علما سهل الله به سهل الله له به طريقا إلى الجنة. وما اجتمع قوم في بيت من بيوت الله يتلون كتاب الله ويتدارسونه ما فيما بينهم إلا نزلت عليهم السكينة وغشيتهم الرحمة وحفتهم الملائكة وذكرهم الله في من عنده. ومن أبطأ به عمله لم يسرع به نسبه. أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. This beautiful hadith narrated by Abu Huraira رضي الله عنه, whose real name was عبد الرحمن بن سفر رضي الله عنه. The reason he is called Abu Huraira because he used to, you know, love cats. He used to keep a lot of cats. That's why he is called Abu Huraira رضي الله عنه. And this Sahabi, Abu Huraira radiyallahu anhu, is the one who narrated the most ahadith from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he's narrating this beautiful hadith that summarizes some of those things, brothers, that are a very essential part of our unity. When we talk about one ummah, when we talk about the unity, when we talk about some of the differences sometimes we feel and see in the community, even in the family members as well. So Rasulullah beautifully mentioning some of these things, that if we have it as a believer, wallahi, it will be something that can help us to unite us together. It will help us to resolve so many issues. It will help us to build a mahabba for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, سَبْعَةٌ يُظِلُّهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي ظِلِّهِ يَوْمَ لَا ظِلَّ إِلَّا ظِلٌّ. There will be 7 people under the shade of Allah Azza wa Jalla on the Day of Judgment, when there will be no shade except His shade. And one of them will be 2 people, وَرَجُلَانِ تَحَابَّ فِي اللَّهِ اجْتَمَعَ عَلَيْهِ وَتَفَرَّقَ عَلَيْهِ. Those 2 people who used to love each other for Allah's sake, they used to meet each other for Allah's sake, and they used to depart each other for Allah's sake, meaning their relationship was for Allah Azza wa Jal. Ask yourself and ask myself, you know, I will ask myself also this question. When we have those people who are close to us, the person who is your best friend, why he is your best friend? What is the base of that relationship? Is it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or is it only, why? Because you know him, you know he is, you know, in your in the same business that you are in, or he is working in the same place, or that love is only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in this hadith, مَنْ نَفَّسَ عَنْ مُؤْمِنٍ كُرْبَةً مِنْ كُرَبِ الدُّنْيَا نَفَّسَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ كُرْبَةً مِنْ كُرَبِ يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. Allahu Akbar. That a person who removes any difficulty of a believer in this dunya, Allah will remove his difficulty on the Day of Judgment. Allahu Akbar. What will be the difficulty of the Day of Judgment, brothers? The difficulty of the Day of Judgment will be standing in front of Allah Azza wa Jal. Yawm al-Qiyamah, the day of standing. The day we will stand there for thousands of months or years. That will be the difficult day. The difficulty of that day will be the sun will be so close to us. The difficulty of that day will be we are going to receive our book of deed in right or left hand. The difficulty of that day will be either Jannah or Jahannam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you remove the difficulty of a believer in this dunya, Allah Azza wa Jal will remove your difficulty on the Day of Judgment. وَمَنْ يَسَّرَ عَلَى مُعْسِرٍ يَسَّرَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. Whoever eases someone, there is a problem of a believer, and you are the one who eases that problem, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ease your issues, your problem of this dunya and the hereafter. What's the difference between first and second? In the first part of the hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam uses the word kurbatan min kurabi dunya. And the second one, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the second line says, وَمَنْ يَسَّرَ. So the first thing is any problem, any difficulty of a person might not be related to you. But in the second sentence, وَمَنْ يَسَّرَ عَلَى مُعْسِرٍ. For example, someone borrowed money from you and now he is unable to pay you back. He is asking for some more time. You are trying to ease his difficulty. Someone is looking for a job and you are the one who can ease, you know, that difficulty of that person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ease your difficulties of this dunya and the hereafter. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَمَنْ سَتَرَ مُسْلِمًا ومن ستر مسلما ستره الله في الدنيا والآخرة. Whoever covers the sins or shortcomings of a believer, Allah subhanahu in this dunya, Allah will cover his fault in this dunya and in the hereafter. You know, one of the hadiths there, the meaning of the hadith, there will be a people whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how he will judge them on the day of judgment, will be so close to them, so close to them. Allah Azza wa Jalla will hold them accountable in that way that none will know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking them. Those will be the category of the people. One of the category of those people will be who used to cover the faults of others, the sins of others, the shortcomings of others in this dunya. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will cover their shortcomings, their sins, their faults on the day of judgment. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَمَنْ سَلَكَ طَرِيقًا يَلْتَمِسُ فِيهِ عِلْمًا سَهَّلَ اللَّهُ لَهُ بِهِ طَرِيقًا مِنْ طُرُقِ الْجَنَّةِ. That whoever takes the path, and sorry, before that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَاللَّهُ فِي عَوْنِ الْعَبْدِ مَا كَانَ الْعَبْدُ فِي عَوْنِ أَخِيهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala support his slave as long as he is supporting one of his slaves. Meaning that Rasulullah ﷺ mentioned about removing the difficulty or making it easy for other person, or not, you know, covering up the sins and shortcomings. And then he's saying that's not only three things. Then Rasulullah ﷺ is basically summarizing it that وَاللَّهُ فِي عَوْنِ الْعَبْدِ مَا كَانَ. As long as you are supporting one of the slaves of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will keep on supporting you in any way possible. We are the ummah of service. We are the ummah of khidmah. That should be the attitude of a believer, of a true mu'min, that he is always there in the service of others. That's his attitude. Whenever someone is in need, whatever way that individual, that mu'min can help that person, he should. Why? Because in return, he is not expecting any reward from that person. لا نريد منكم جزاء ولا شكورا. He is expecting the reward only from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, ومن سلك طريقا يلتمس فيه علما سهل الله له به طريقا إلى الجنة. Whoever walks on the path of knowledge, seeking knowledge, Allah Azza wa Jalla will let him to walk on the path that leads to Jannah. And you know, the spoiler of this hadith, all of a sudden, Rasulullah was mentioning about removing the difficulty, you know, becoming a source of easiness for someone, and covering up the faults, being supportive of others. And now why Rasulullah in the same hadith is mentioning about the knowledge? As one of, you know, some of the scholars, they say, once you have the knowledge, the true knowledge, the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the knowledge of the deen of Allah azza wa jal, that will help you to have, the reflection of that will be in the mu'amalat. And those mu'amalat that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, especially in this hadith, covering up the sins, being helpful to others, removing the difficulties. And look at the next one. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَمَجْتَمَعَ قَوْمٌ فِي بَيْتٍ مِّن بُيُوتِ اللَّهِ يَتْلُونَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ وَيَتَدَارَسُونَهُ فِيمَا بَيْنَهُمْ. Those people who get together in the masajid of Allah, in one of the houses of Allah Azza wa Jal, and what they do? يَتْلُونَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ. They read the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. وَيَتَدَارَسُونَهُ مَا فِيمَا بَيْنَهُمْ. They teach each other. يَتَدَارَسُونَهُ. They learn from each other. إِلَّا نَزَلَتْ عَلَيْهِمُ السَّكِينَةِ. When they do so, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the sakina, the tranquility descends on them. The angels, they cover them, subhanallah. When you are busy in reciting the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you are in the process of learning and teaching the book of Allah azza wa jal, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, نَزَلَتْ عَلَيْهِمُ السَّكِينَةِ. The tranquility descends on those kind of people. حَفَّتْهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. The angels, they surround them. غَشِيَتْهُمُ الرَّحْمَةِ. The mercy, the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala surrounds them. And you know what happens next? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned those people who are close to him, meaning the angel of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the malaika. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned those people in front of them. And then the last part of the hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَمَنْ أَبْطَرَ بِهِ عَمَلُهُ لَمْ يُسْرِعْ بِهِ نَسَلُهُ. What it means that your nasab, your lineage, your, you know, it will not save you if you have any shortcoming in your a'mal. On the day of judgment, a person whose lineage was strong, but his a'mal was weak, it doesn't mean that his lineage will save him. وَمَنْ أَبْطَأَ بِهِ عَمَلُهُ لَمْ يُسْرِعْ بِهِ نَسَبُهُ. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make all of us among those who removes the difficulty of others, who are source of easiness for others, who are the one who covers the faults and shortcomings of others. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله الواحد الأحد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. قال سبحانه: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين، وأذل الشرك والمشركين، ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين. اللهم أصلح أحوال المسلمين في كل مكان، اللهم ألف بين قلوبهم، وأصلح ذات بينهم، واهدهم سبل السلام. يا مالك الملك، نسألك بأسمائك الحسنى وصفاتك العلى ألا تدع لنا ذنبا إلا غفرته، ولا هما إلا فرجته، ولا كربا إلا نفسته، ولا مبتلا إلا عافيته، ولا ميتا إلا رحمته، ولا مريضا إلا شفيته، ولا دعاء إلا استجبته. يا أرحم الراحمين، اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا، وارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا، وارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى، واجعل آخر كلامنا من الدنيا شهادة أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدا رسول الله، وتوفنا وأنت راض عنا بغير غضبان. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أقم الصلاة.